All right, all praises, honor, and glory unto the Most High Yah. I thank him for your lives, and you're all welcome. I pray that you're doing well on today, this blessed Sabbath day of the Most High Yah. All right, so I do have to be honest with you and say that this is something that I was a bit apprehensive, but I'm a bit apprehensive about sharing. Mainly because when I'm dealing with spiritual topics, or non-secular topics, I always want to be able to share something and give you line upon line scriptural foundation to support what was shared. Okay. Now, there are times when we do have to share things that come directly from the Holy Spirit, but it does not mean that we do not seek the Most High Yah, and we do not seek to balance what was shared according to the Spirit of Christ, all right? That we judge all things, all right? And the scripture says that he who is spiritual judgeth all things, right? Yet he is judged of no man. And so I'm going to share something. I do not like to share dreams, mainly because I never want to come off flaky. All right, that's that self there. We all have that self that we want to preserve. Sometimes it's good, self-preservation. And it's not only good, sometimes it's safe, especially when dealing with spiritual things that can impact other people's lives. But then sometimes it's selfish, meaning that we strictly want to preserve our self-image, and it's not really yielded to the Spirit of Christ where he can use us. All right. But I, in obedience to the Most High, I'm going to share this. Now, this isn't one I had today. Actually, for 2 days, I've been meditating on this. And I'm just going to share it. All right. And I pray that it will help some. And it's not for everyone. It's specifically to those who are commandment keeping, young, old, wherever, in between men, all right? Those who are the sons of Yah, who keep the commandments of Yah, or at least strive to keep his commandments and teach others to do so, okay? I had a night vision, and actually it wasn't, it was in between night and morning, because I'd already, I'd been up, and then I went back, early morning, and went back to sleep. But in this early morning vision, there was a young man, or when I say young, someone, no, he wasn't 50, okay, under 50, but he lived in the South, and I can tell that it was in the South because of where his home was. He lived in a mobile home. It was a nice mobile home. It was like a double wide, or maybe a triple wide, if you're familiar with those. All right, and he was at home alone. I want to say that he had locks, okay? But in his home, I knew it was in the South, because I saw mossy oaks in his yard, okay? And so if you're familiar with trees, you know that mossy oaks only grow in certain states, okay? And so I saw the oak trees with the moss in his yard, a nice big tree near his mobile home on the outside. But he was in the home, and something happened in between some disturbance, either outside. It was either some sort of fire or gunfire or something on the outside, right? And it caused him to go outside. But before he went outside, he took a weapon with him. He took a gun outside with him. The timing, it was not midday. It was either early afternoon, early evening, or early morning, okay, because of the amount of light. But he took a weapon with him outside because of the noise that he heard, or something to get him to come out. Something happened to get him to come outside. When he went outside, he did have his weapon by his side, but there was a young man out there who he was familiar with, or a man out there who he was familiar with, who he was teaching the scriptures to. He was teaching the commandments of Yah to. And so when he saw this guy, he kind of he put his weapon down, and he felt comfortable, although he was disturbed by what had happened that he heard from the outside, or some warning, either fire or gunfire or something that got him to come out. But he knew to grab his weapon. But because he saw this young man that he was familiar with, who was also an African-American man, he put his weapon down by his side. He was still holding it. And when he did this, he let his guard down, so to speak. This young man who he had been teaching the scriptures to actually killed him. Okay? So he trusted this guy because he had opened his home. In fact, he had invited this guy to his home, and he was teaching him the scriptures. But what he had done, basically, is open the door for an enemy. All right? And so what I believe the Most High Yah is saying to the commandment-keeping young men is that you need to be very, very careful, even with those who approach you stating that they want you to teach them the scriptures. Because in the vision, I knew that the young man was actually on assignment. All right, he was given an assignment to take out this commandment keeping young man. Okay, now the man, or I keep saying young, but he was under 50. All right, and he did have locks. I do believe that when he ran out of the house, he had on shorts. He didn't have a shirt on. All right. But he did grab his weapon. But because he saw a familiar face, he put the weapon down. And so when you are doing the service of the Most High and helping others, do not put your weapons down. Do not see your brothers always as enemies. But you have to keep on the full armor of Yah. And from that, I also realized that when you are bringing in new people to teach them the word of Yah, to teach them the commandments, you should also have others there. Be careful of those who you allow, even in your inner circle, without knowing them. All right? Know those people, not only those that have rule over you, all right, but know those who labor among you, all right, as the scripture teaches us. And so, as the vision went on, the number 1200 came up. That this young man that was killed, he was supposed to be a part of 1200 commandment-keeping men. Now, 1200, I know that the Bible speaks about 144,000. So I'm like, yeah, what is this 1200 number? Does it have any significance? But in the vision, it was a group of 1200 commandment-keeping men who were planning to get together for some sort of convention or some meeting that they were having around the scripture, okay? And so when you are sharing, I do believe the word of Yah to us is that, and to those men, be careful. Always, Christ always sent them out two by two or seven, you know, grouped together. Be careful, okay? Even among those who approach you stating that they want to study and know the word of Yah. Know that the enemy will even use familiar people or people who appear to be like you to infiltrate and to destroy. Okay? So we must be wise as serpents, harmless as doves, always walk in love. Okay? The scripture lets us know that they will know that we are his disciples because we have love one toward another. But Yah's love is not blind, neither is it ignorant. Okay? And so we should not be ignorant of Satan's devices. And so this young man, I do believe he was in a southern state. I do believe he had locks. I do believe from the vision that the home that he lived in was a at least a double wide or a triple wide. And that may not be the exact house. It was, if you're from the South, if somebody has a double wide or a triple wide, it's considered a pretty nice mobile home, right? Because they're very modern, module type homes, okay? He wasn't living a lavish life, but he had his own land, and he had his own comfortable house, all right? Comfortable. So you have to be very wise, okay? Satan sends enemies sometimes even to scout out. And so that's it. I don't want to add to it. I do want to say that the scripture, after I was meditating on this, Isaiah 26, the Most High took me to Isaiah 26, and in particular verse 10, but I ended up reading all of it. And Isaiah 26 verse 10 says, "Let favor be showed to the wicked, yet will he not learn righteousness. In the land of uprightness will he deal unjustly, and will not behold the majesty of the Lord or of Yehovah." Okay? Now, when I first read this, I thought about the U.S. and Israel. Okay? I thought about the U.S., all right, how Yah has shown us favor, and I thought about the land of uprightness in Israel, all right, and how they would still deal unjustly, even if given the land of uprightness. But when I thought about this, right, this is the scripture that came to mind right after that dream. And it lets us know that even among the wicked, if you show them favor, you bring them in close, if they are wicked in heart, let favor be shown to the wicked, yet he will not learn righteousness. And this is what the man was teaching him. He was trying to teach him righteousness, teaching him the commandments of the Most High Yah. And even in the land of uprightness will he deal unjustly, and will not behold the majesty of Yehovah. All right? So let us deal wisely, and let us know that even if you show favor, if the person is wicked in heart, all right, you open up your heart, your home, your life to them, they will still not learn righteousness. All right? There is a remnant, and there are people who will learn and obey. But be wise as serpents and harmless as doves, and know that you have an adversary who is the devil, who goes about as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour in one way or another. All right? Yah bless the people of Yah. Yah bless the commandment keeping sons of Yah. And may you rise up and teach others, but be wise. Shalom.